Tesla just finished a massive project down the street from my place. They installed 21 chargers and it took almost a year to complete. It looks pretty awesome, so I wanted to show you guys what it looks like and point out a couple things that I found interesting. You'll often hear people say, oh, we don't have enough power on the grid to support EV chargers, but that's actually not true. What we don't have is the infrastructure to support these chargers, and that's largely the transformers. What transformers do, and bear with me, I'm not an electrician, but I'll explain this in basic terms as far as I understand it. Transformers convert the electricity down to a lower strength so that common equipment can use the power. The electricity that's coming out of those towers or those electrical lines are running at a super high voltage. These transformers are actually called step-down transformers, and they step the electrical current down to a lower voltage so that common equipment can receive the electricity. In this case, the Tesla Superchargers still have a pretty high output at 250 kilowatts, but the electricity still needs to be stepped down. The next thing I wanted to point out was the connector plug. Tesla cars use the NACS connector, which is the NACS, and this stands for the North American Charging Standard. Other car manufacturers mostly use the J1772 plug or sometimes the CHAdeMO plug. So in the past, they haven't been compatible. But just recently, Elon Musk, I guess, was generous enough to open up the Tesla charging network, and now non-Tesla cars can, in theory, charge at Tesla superchargers. The thing is that they'll need an adapter to attach to their connector plug so that it can work with the Tesla superchargers. The next thing I wanted to point out, which might be an odd little issue, is where the cord is located on the superchargers. The cord comes out of the right side of the Tesla superchargers because the Tesla cars have their charge port on that side, but many non-Tesla cars have their charge port on the opposite side. Those cords are actually pretty short on the Tesla superchargers. But why does this matter? Well, non-Tesla cars, they're gonna have to use the charger that's next to the stall that they parked in. I don't know how Tesla drivers feel about sharing their charging network with non-Tesla drivers, but if these non-Tesla drivers end up having to take up two spots just to use one charger, there may be a few battles at these supercharger locations. Hopefully that's not the case and everybody gets along, but that's just something unique I wanted to point out. Okay, the biggest thing here is the concrete. As you might have noticed, there's two different colors of concrete there. One's darker and one's lighter. The darker section of concrete is all brand new. This is because in order to install these superchargers, they had to dig up all that concrete to run all the wiring underground. This was a massive undertaking and was probably the biggest reason why this project took so long. This is called trenching, and along with the transformers will by far be the most expensive part of the project. Not only is it very time consuming, but you'll also need to get a permit from the city to dig up all that concrete. As you can probably tell, I'm pretty excited to have these Tesla superchargers just down the street. And although they're not up and running yet, it's gonna be a nice amenity to have. I hope you enjoyed seeing these chargers just as much as I did. And if you want to continue following the journey, feel free to subscribe to my channel for more. Thanks so much for checking in, and I'll catch you on the next one. Cheers.